Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick here in North Carolina. I've been trying to make a video for several videos that the Lord's given me to make. Been praying, brothers and sisters, about where I'm going to go. The Lord has had me holding here in North Carolina for a couple extra weeks beyond what I intended, you know, and we have to be obedient to the Lord, brothers and sisters. Try to be as much as we can, and that's, you know, that's what grace is for. When we slip up and miss the mark is really the literal translation of when it talks about sinning. The literal translation is miss the mark. You know, you it's like shooting an arrow and you miss the target. So we repent, and then His mercies are new every morning. We try again. Anyway, brothers and sisters, the Joshua's ministry, I just wanted to talk about that a little bit. I need to make a new slideshow of the feedings in the orphanage. I usually do one of the orphanage and then a different one of the feedings, like a video with music. Anyway, the Lord has just been separating out in every area. You know, you can look in your life and see patterns of God. So right now I've been having a pattern of what God's doing in Joshua's ministry. And I believe He's preparing us to take us to a whole new level. As an example, before someone was sending the books out for me, and now I'm doing it myself. Or actually, there's another sister who I'd left some books with in Las Vegas, she's going to send out those books for me first, and she's got about 80 books up there. Anyway, so as an example, after I got the books, and then I made a video about it, the first video really kind of advertising the books. I got the book around here somewhere. Hold on a second. Within arm's reach. Ha-ha! I do have the book right here. You know, I wanted to thank the Lord for that, because it's over the time. We just sold one book here and there. Of course, it's a love offering. And the proceeds go to Joshua's ministry. I mean, I wrote the book, you know, as because the Lord gave me this message to bring revival to the end times church. That's why it's called Final Boarding Call. It's Final Boarding Call Before the Rapture. Satan's Plan for the Ages, which is culminated with the Antichrist. And then Our Last Mission. So what do? While we're waiting on the rapture, instead of setting dates, you know, people email me all the time saying, you know, they've been disillusioned with the date setting and all that. And we do not know the day of the hour. It is soon. It could be tomorrow. It could be 5 years from now. We don't know. In the meantime, we have a mission. That's to bring in the final harvest. As Jesus said, He tied the rapture to the fullness of the Gentiles. And Jesus said that until the fullness of the Gentiles comes, you know, and then He said that this gospel of the kingdom will be preached to the whole world, and then the end shall come. So our real commission to motivate us to win all those last souls is Jesus, the Lord, God, the Father has a final count of how many Gentiles will come into the bride to be raptured, and then it will happen. So our real mission is to get as many people truly saved, not with the false gospel of greasy grace and all this, and just without repentance, you know, and that's what God is using me for, and people like me, to bring true salvation through true repentance. And I just want to, some people keep asking me for names of good preachers. A preacher who preaches the stuff I'm talking about, who was a mighty man of God, he's dead now, and maybe in 1999. His name is Leonard Ravenhill. You can look him up. He was a street preacher in England, was involved in some revivals when he was a young man in the 1950s with A.W. Tozier and this Campbell up in Scotland. They had a real revival, a real move of God. Not a series of meetings, but a real move of God. And I mention this all the time. There's something called the Revival Hymn. It's about 34 minutes long. You find that on YouTube and you listen to that. That is the secret to bringing in this last harvest. Preaching like John Wesley did. Go read about John Wesley, who founded the Methodist. Way back in the day, the Great Awakening in the United States. That's the kind of preaching, that's the kind of evangelizing that we need to do that will have the Lord respond and move mightily in what is called a revival. Not a series of meeting, but a sovereign move of God upon the hearts of the lost, and also upon the church to holiness and repentance. Anyway, brothers and sisters, since I got the books now in my possession, after in the past we probably, I don't know, but just like last week, we had 40 books were bought. A huge amount. More than, you know, almost as many as we've sold in a whole year. And so, you know, it's when I got the books back, it seems like it's a negative thing, but God has a plan. God is moving in that plan. Just like I had to, you know, give back the van. I thank Sister Elaine for letting me use her van. She was so nice to let me use it. And she needed it back, and now I've got the RV. you know, temporarily. I know the Lord will provide a vehicle that uses less gas and all. It's practical to drive around. It's not very practical to, you know, go around town in an RV, you know, because of gas and the size and trying to park it and all that. It can be tedious. But I know that the Lord is separating me from that vehicle, separating from me from, you know, about the shipping of the books. And now also the PayPal. You know, God works in patterns, and He's setting us up for something better. Brother Martin M. Corland, who handles the PayPal donations for Joshua's ministry for the orphanage and the feedings, that's separate for him. If you buy a book or the U.S. or international operations like me, if I'm in the States or if I go to Canada or Europe, as the Lord leads me into Australia and all these places that the Lord has spoken to me about, and I've had invitations to go. I just got to have time to go there. By the grace of God, to preach the gospel, the true gospel of repentance and holiness, to bring repentance, true repentance and salvation in the hearts of people and into the church, to bring revival. That Australia has got a rule, and, you know, PayPal is making themselves the New World Order police. They have a rule that you have to be a licensed fundraiser in Australia in order to transfer funds out of the country. You know, so that's some new law. I'm sure they do, or they will have something similar here in the States. So from now on, we can't use that PayPal in Australia to transfer to the Philippines, because there's really no PayPal. On the island that I'm on in the Philippines, there is no PayPal. You know, so, and there is PayPal at some banks in Manila, and then they charge these huge fees. And lots of people have had their money stolen and scammed. I mean, look, the Philippines is a third world country for a reason, okay? You cannot even trust, you can't really basically trust the banks either, generally speaking. And so people have had their money stolen and scammed through the banks, and the fees are so high, you're just better off to send Western Union and bypass all that. And even though it's a fee there, it's cheaper. But the route we've been using for the last 2 years with Brother Martin, the Lord has allowed that to be removed. And so now there's another brother who lives in another Western country, and the laws are not gone there yet, or maybe they will, or maybe they won't. At this time, they're not. So this brother's first name is Peter. We're going to try to line up the account, and we're running a test run now. So in the meantime, if you want to donate for the orphanages and the feeding programs, brothers and sisters, that's really why I'm making this video. You send it to me, to my email, neartochrist@aol.com, and then if you, there's a comment section on there. You can write, you know, like if you put your address to order the book, you put in there and say, Brother Patrick, here's $200. I want it to go for the feeding of the children, or here's $200 or $100. I want it to go for the orphanage. Okay, and then I'll have that. And then when we're going to test, I already sent him $100, and then he's going to, because he's just set it up the account and into his bank account, and then he'll transfer it from this Western country over to the Philippines, and to the bank account of the house mom of orphanage number one. She's handling the. I have a treasurer too, who also has an account, but the house mom is really my primary source, her and the treasurer, to work with the money for Joshua's ministry there in the Philippines. So anyway, brothers and sisters, we're going to do a test run, and it takes like a week. It takes like 3 days to transfer from your PayPal account to your checking account. Why that is, I don't know. This is year 2014. Probably something to do with a man, the New World Order, and then it takes about 3 days to transfer from your bank account to arrive in the Philippines to the bank account there. And the reason there is because they're just slow, you know, to do an international transfer. So we're going to test this and get it lined up. And as soon as this week is over and everything's cool and this brother is, you know, satisfied that it's fine with him and he's checking all these things out and that make sure there's no problem with the government of his country and all that, then we're going to go with that account. In the meantime, like I say, you send it to me. I can always do a bank transfer from here. You know, I don't know. You know, I got to research myself all of the, some kind of limitations or what. You know, if need be, I can also hand carry it when I go back. You know, you can carry money with you internationally up to $10,000, even though I don't want to do that. I'd rather do a bank transfer for safety reasons. But, you know, we're going to pray about it and work it out. There may be other sources besides PayPal. You know, PayPal is the biggest one, but there may be others who are not so Nazified to do the will of the New World Order as PayPal has been. And as a matter of fact, since this has been going on the last few weeks where it's been questionable whether they're going to not let us use the account or let us use it, we've been trying to work with PayPal for the last 2 or 3 weeks about this, the brother in Australia, Brother Martin. I've been reading all the horror stories on the internet about people dealing with PayPal, even people in the States. Their accounts have been frozen. Even my brother, he's an IT guy, my older brother, he does computer and all this router. He sets up routers between like a network of banks. I guess they call it an intranet. And even his PayPal, because he does some business with computer stuff on the side, and they froze his account for no real reason. It took him 2 or 3 months to get it unlocked. And it seems to be kind of a standard thing with PayPal. So maybe PayPal is something to be avoided. I'm going to, check it out more. Of course, if this works, we'll use this. And if, as the New World Order is progressing and this gets closed down, then we'll have another route, brothers and sisters, as the Lord would provide. You know that the current administration is really an enemy of Christianity, you know, like the IRS investigating Christian groups and all this. And we know that, the kingdom of the Antichrist is coming. And so these restrictions and stuff, like, you know, you can give, they wanted you to do it through the UN and all this, a non-Christian, you know, a secular, like UNICEF and all this kind of stuff. They don't want people to do it through Christian organizations and charities. They're trying to drive Christianity out of, doing work like this, like the orphanages and stuff. And that's why even President Bush, a lot of people can't seem to get grasp the point that all these presidents are just puppets for the New World Order. President Bush did the faith-based initiative. Ultimately, what happens is the government's given money to these poor churches, and then they're coming in and telling the church, well, you got to hire gay people, you got to marry gay people, you got to do this, that, and the other, because you took money from us. That's really the reason why they're doing it. Brothers and sisters, you know, I kind of wrote about that in the book, not on that specific topic. Aha! Well, brothers and sisters, you know, when I move these books to get the message out, it's also for the benefit of the orphanage. So, hey, you know, I got to do what I got to do. But it is true that just like with what they've done in the schools, brothers and sisters, way back in the 60s, they came in and said, we want to give federal money to these poor school districts in the South and, you know, Mississippi, Alabama, even North Carolina, all these schools, Arkansas and all that. And then they come in and say, okay, since we gave you money, you got to do this, that, and the other. But in reality, that money is not the federal government's. That money was taken in taxes from the people anyway. And then they redistribute it where they want to. And then they come in and dictate how and when and where, why, how you can use the money. Just like, the First Lady now, you know, they're trying to dictate what foods that they serve in the school from the federal government. And every area of our lives is more and more like that, brothers and sisters. So this thing with PayPal, I ask you not to be discouraged. If they were to close our account again, the worst thing to happen is that, you know, from that PayPal account, we could send you your donation back. So it won't be lost. They're not really seizing it and taking it. They can't do that unless it was some kind of, you know, you're some kind of a terror, you know, they proved in court that it was some kind of a terrorist money laundering thing or drug money laundering thing. That's what they claim they're looking for. And I believe there's some truth to that. And of course, they need to, stop some people that might be doing that. Of course, I understand that. But like I said, all the people that donated so far were Brother Martin. All the money's going to be clear. It's just we can't accept new donations into Australia and then shipped out to the Philippines. And like I said, if there's something comes up, we can always send it back to you, and then you can send it by Western Union or whatever. So there's no need to worry. No need to, this is just. You know, the Lord is preparing us for something bigger and better some other way. I don't know how today, but I know it will be. Just like with the books. We sold more books, have went out than in the whole time since I wrote the book. You know, and God is setting us up. You know, like the vehicle situation. I know the Lord's going to give me a better vehicle than what I had. It'll be something better that I need that'll fit perfectly with what He wants me to do. Same thing with the PayPal situation. God will provide something bigger and better. So in all of your situations, it's the same thing. Brothers and sisters, I make this video so to be a living example to you of how God works in our lives. Just like in the Bible, the apostles, in the book of Acts, we see, you know, there's things that happened to Paul and Peter and all them, and even the Lord Jesus Christ, you know, we see it as an example, how we should react, how we should relate to God, how these mighty men of God and women of God in the Bible related to God. That's our, as the Bible says, those are our examples, as King James, samples, but examples in modern English. God bless you guys. Thank you for all those who have donated to Joshua's ministry. That's another test we've had since we've been in the States. We've been barely making our budget through prayer, which we never had a problem with that in the past, or the last 2 months since we've been in the States. And I know the Lord is got big things coming, and the enemy don't like it, but God's going to give us the breakthrough. God's going to make a way. So I'm just thanking him in advance. And that's faith, brothers and sisters. Walking by faith and not by sight. Calling those things as if they are when they're not. In other words, like God called Abram, changed his name to Abraham, father of many nations. And he had no children. 75, no children. And then God changed his name from father to father of many nations. So that's the same thing we do, brothers and sisters. We believe, we confess, and by faith, you know, God provides according to our belief, by our faith, brothers and sisters. Just like salvation, it's by grace through faith. So the things we acquire from God is through faith. The Bible says without faith it's impossible to please him, and he is a rewarder of them who diligently seek him. Hebrews 11:7. So the same thing is true with anything, brothers and sisters. It's acquired by faith. And then someone would say, well, you know, we, as it says in the Bible, if we pray according to his will, you know we have those things we ask. Now, you know, that's where it comes in. And in James says, you know, we ask to consume on our own lust. We ask amiss. That's true, brothers and sisters. That's when our personal walk, sanctification, and holiness, walking with the Lord comes into play. Because the Bible says if a man's ways are pleasing to God, he will give you the desires of your heart. So when we're really walking with the Lord, I see it in a reverse way. Not that, oh, I'm praying for A and God gives me A. No, I'm saying the Bible verse means that God puts the desire in my heart for A, and then he's going to give me A when I pray it out and I believe it and confess it and stand on it and wait and anticipate and look by faith that God's going to give it. Faith is a substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen, is the King James way of saying Hebrews 11:1. Hebrews 11 is a chapter on faith, one of the biggest ones, FYI. So you have to believe it before you see it. As the Lord said in Mark chapter 11, verse 22, 23, and 24, he said, have faith in God. You know, whomsoever shall say to this mountain, be thou removed and cast into the sea, and not doubt in his heart, but shall believe those things he saith. When he says it, he shall have whatsoever he saith. You got to say it. The Lord says say it more than believe. He says say like five, six times in that expression, in those three verses. And then belief, he only says like three times. So you have to say it. Jesus said, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. Now this is, and I just want to say this. They talk about this naming and claiming. It's not naming and claiming. Because, as I just said, if your desires are carnal and earthly, of course, you're out of line with the Word of God. As an example, when I was in the Philippines, we were doing a revival. And they invited this preacher in. He was a prosperity preacher. His first name is Ali. They called him Ali. I guess his name is Alexander or Alejandro. Something like that. Anyway, he took up his donations in his church in a wheelbarrow that he spray painted gold. You know, and every morning at 5 o'clock, they would chant for an hour, money cometh, money cometh, money cometh. And he came in when I was doing a revival. He preached one of the nights in this revival we had in this town. And he got up there and preached, you know, that God was going to give him a brand new, it's called a Pajero. This is kind of like the dream car of Filipinos. Is a Pajero. It's kind of like a four-wheel drive thing. I can't remember. I think Mitsubishi makes it, but whatever. But he was saying, like, God was going to give it to him because he's going to go cruising around in it. You see what I mean? But if you got up there and said, I'm believing the Lord for a four-wheel drive vehicle because I want to go to the top of the dirt roads in the Philippines, 90% of the roads outside the cities are dirt. And I need a four-wheel drive Pajero because I'm going to drive to the top of the mountains up there, and I'm going to reach a native tribe that's never been reached, and I'm going to evangelize them. And I got to be able to get up there, and I want to take some, translator. I want to take some Bibles. I want to take some guitars for a church that we plant so they can have music. And so we need a vehicle to carry all this stuff in there, up there in, because you can only get there on foot now. And I've been to lots of places in the Philippines. I walked like 18 hours, 2 days to get to places because there's no roads. You can't even get there on a horse. They claim you could probably get there on a dirt bike, but for me, I didn't think you could do that. Anyway, the house dad of House Orphanage Number One, he went with me there when he was one of my students. 2007, we went to these remote areas and to rebel, the NPA, the New People's Army, rebel territory, in a place like that, that if you had some kind of four-wheel drive vehicle, you might be able to go across country and get there. So as an example, if you were praying for that, Lord, give me this vehicle so I could go there, so I can do your work, do your will, that is the kind of thing that God would provide. Not, Lord, give me a car so I can be cool and cruise. You see the difference, brothers and sisters? That's the difference between, some kind of naming and claiming and some of these preachers on TV, they're bragging up that they're driving around in the brand new Mercedes and all this. There's a preacher out there in Los Angeles somewhere, I think it is. I forgot his name. It's a black preacher. And he's talking about, you know, all of his kids driving all these, you know, $200,000 cars and all that. And, you know, that's a whole different thing, brothers and sisters. There's a difference. That's where we got to be. We got to be in it. You know, God, just like me, I say, Lord, if I had $50,000, I could build a new orphanage. You know, Lord, provide everything to build an orphanage. I need a house, mom and dad. We need the orphans who will not run away and all this. I need a pastor to oversee the spiritual growth of the children locally, because I can't be everywhere. This stuff is all spread out over 3 or 4 or 5 hours away from each other. And then I need $50,000 to build an orphanage, you know, and I need the right good construction workers, and they won't try to scam us and all that stuff, brothers and sisters. I need the government to give us a permit to hook up the stuff and all this, you know, for the electricity and all that. So Lord, provide all these things. You see, that's the kind of things that we can repeat it and believe it, and God will provide, brothers and sisters. That's the kind of things I'm talking about. Anyway, God bless you guys. I tried to have lots of messages that the Lord gave me. As you know, I'm in this hotel room, so I haven't been able to do it. By the grace of God, on Saturday, I'll be moving to a place with a separate bedroom, and I'm still waiting on the Lord to hear where I should go, because I've got the RV. It gets about 10 to 15 miles a gallon, brothers and sisters. As I looked it up online, it claims it can get up to 15 on the highway. I haven't experienced that good of a mileage in it, so it's maybe a little bit dangerous to be driving it so far, unless you're so focused. It's pretty tedious. So I'm praying about that. Still, even though Saturday is coming up, I'm still unsure if I will go through Little Rock to Dallas, or if I will go just closer in this area. I don't know, brothers and sisters. That's why I ask you to pray, comment, pray about this also. Give me feedback. I'm thinking about going down and connecting with Brother Sid along the South Carolina coast and start doing a daily radio show. And that's one thing that that we can do for the ministry that I believe the Lord would use mightily through the website, Church of the Firstborn. So I ask you to pray about that. Pray, Brother Sid and I, if we should do that now. Because I want to go and do what God wants me to do, and I want to do it in His timing. And so I'm just still waiting on the Lord. I've stayed here 2 extra weeks waiting on the Lord, and still waiting on the Lord for His plans. So I ask for your prayers, your encouragement, your comments, feedback, and I'm praying for all those who've asked me to pray for them. And if you have prayer requests and words for people, I still need to do that, some more of that, as the Lord leads me. I'm still here. I've given people words privately. Since I've been here, I've been basically giving words to people privately, you know, as the Lord led me. So God bless you guys. I'll talk to you later.